and work in the African marketplace. Okay? How many of you are affiliates? So you're here to learn. Very good. And how many of you are operators? Okay, very good. Well, thank you very much. So I will let my distinguished panelists introduce themselves and then we'll get cracking.
Hi, good afternoon. Thank you for the distinguished. My name is Alessandro Pizzolotto. I'm the CEO of STM Gaming. We are a platform provider, so we provide platform on to every operator in not every, unfortunately, but to many operators in the African market. So,
hi, my name is Leanne Johnston, and I'm the CEO and founder of Affiliate Insider. We're an affiliate marketing agency, and we're also a training company, and I also work with affiliates as a business mentor and coach.
Hello, I'm Mark Tipping. I'm a director of Eazibet Africa, which is licensed and operating online in South Africa, Zambia, Ghana, and Kenya.
Brilliant. So how about we start with what countries in Africa, because we can't talk about Africa as one since it's got 54 different countries, which countries would we say are early adopters and what would you say are the ones that are up and coming? What's in your experience? Who are the powerhouses? I know we can talk about Nigeria, Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda, but in your experience, which marketplaces do you think are making strides specifically in affiliate marketing?
From where the territories we're working in, South Africa has become a very interesting one recently because some legislation loosening has meant that revenue share deals can actually take place between operators and affiliates without the need previously for those affiliates to almost be go through probability and due diligence as a sharer of revenue. They used to go through probability. So South Africa is one that's just jumped up hugely over the last year or so as they've loosened that element of approval process for advertising. So in the countries I'm in, South Africa is definitely the most mature in that respect.
And is that just for sports betting or
product-wise? With the local licensing, online casinos are illegal. So the only online betting within South Africa is sports betting, but the sports betting companies are getting quite clever as to how they manage to present games that may appear like casino games, but are on a fixed odds rule set. And yeah, so you can look at South African operators and see casino elements, but they're actually under fixed odds regulatory framework.
I would say that East Africa is making a lot of progress. It's obviously Kenya, but all the markets next to Kenya, Tanzania, Zambia, Uganda, they're getting more into the affiliate market, into the online business more than, they are retail-based still, but they get into that market and they start understanding what these guys can bring to them in terms of player, in terms of know-how, and I think they will keep going that direction.
So I just want to basically copy what Mark said in terms of South Africa. So I was out there last year, and just affiliate marketing in general is becoming quite apparent in South Africa, mainly because the infrastructure is there, but also because more and more people are shopping online, and that never used to happen in South Africa. So people are becoming more internet savvy, they're looking for deals, and that really opens up the opportunity for affiliates to start to work in those regions. And the one thing that I noticed when I was out there last year is people have a lot of traffic, they just don't really know what an affiliate is. So there's a little bit of an education piece that's still happening there, where people don't really understand affiliate marketing in the same way that we do here. So any affiliates that are over here are actually entering that market with an advantage because you've got 10, 15 years of digital experience that affiliates that are local to the region are only now starting to kind of get involved in.
I completely agree. I mean, internet penetration is the big thing, and that's very high. Mm. And people have smartphones, so everyone has smartphones, being all around Africa. And besides some nation, most of the nation, they all have a smartphone, and they go online to do all the things. It's just that the operator, besides some big one, don't know how to approach those affiliates, because if you go to Scandinavia, everyone knows how to do online affiliation. In Africa, it's still, we need to teach them, and you can say them, and we can still teach them, we have to teach them how to do it, and I think that the traffic is there, so they can take that traffic, they just need to explain to the operator what is the advantage of having an affiliate working for you.
I mean, the other thing to remember as well is that they don't have developed like GDPR privacy laws. So it's kind of like the wild, wild west still out there in terms of land grab, in terms of finding customers online. So I think for any affiliate that's looking to get into that marketplace, there's a really good opportunity for you to build a brand really quickly because you've got the experience from having digital campaigns and businesses here. But just remember to approach the local market in a different way. And I think localization is something that's also very important. And I know you can probably speak to that in terms of being there. But I think the way that you approach Africa is not plug and play. It's not going to be doing the same things that you do here in order to build communities. It's really about understanding the local community that you're going to focus in.
Yeah, and also, just to add to what Alessandro was saying, I mean, a lot of the content that they create are things like fan-based sites, Facebook. So, for example, there was a gentleman who said he's got about 7 million Facebook followers, but I said to him, what are you doing with it? And he said, nothing. And I was like, sit right down. We need to talk. Because it's a passion. The content is what they're really after. You know, they're football fans at the end of the day, and they're constantly creating content, talking about the players, you know. So that leads me to my next question to the distinguished panelists here, which is from a marketing perspective and a content, what do the audience consume? What is it that they're really looking for? And what can you as affiliates, if you want to go into that marketplace, what do you think would be valuable to have? Leanne, you want to start? And then
Alessandra? So for me, I think what customers are looking for is they're looking for brand reputation and trust. Because this is all very new to them, I think the first thing that you need to do is educate customers on, you know, how to deposit safely, securely. Remember, the market is immature there. So bonus offers aren't necessarily, I think, going to drive your entire acquisition strategy, but rather educating the customer, explaining how online sports betting works, depending on what region you're going into, and talking about the rules and regulations behind it and just giving them that insight. That it's a piece that you don't really think about here because customers here are a lot more savvy. So just breaking it down into the really simple steps of how to get your money in, how to get your money out, what looks like a regulated brand, because they're going to be led by the brands that are investing a lot of money into those markets in terms of marketing. So, you know, the BetNigers, all of those guys, depending on which regions you're going to go into. So I think aligning yourself with brands that are reputable in those countries, first off, as an affiliate, and then educating the customer in terms of transitioning them from like real life betting at a bookmaker or at a bookie on the corner shop to what actually happens in the online physical world.
Alessandro?
I think, I mean, obviously he's going to tell me if I'm right or wrong, but I think it's also about the message you're going to try to promote. Because if you go there telling them, oh, I give you 50 free spin on that specific slot, no one is going to look at that because they don't play slots. So in Africa, obviously, sportbook, virtuals, some casino, not much. I mean, we see the number of our operator. We don't have that many numbers, that big of a number on casino, where sportbook and virtual are by far the most important product. So you need to go out with the right message, focusing on the right product.
But not only the product and the message, it's also about the medium. So, I mean, for example, like we're South Africans, so we can tell you nobody's on Facebook in South Africa. They're all on a WhatsApp group. So if you're trying to build a community in social, that ain't going to work in South Africa. You need to go build a WhatsApp community on their mobile phones and then start seeding all of your content into like tipping or whatever it is that you're going to do. So it's really about understanding the local market. And as Sarafina said at the beginning of the conversation, Africa is not one continent. There are hundreds of, you know, there's lots of different localizations, languages. It's a very, very complex continent to get into. So making sure that you have that localization is really going to be the first part of you winning the customer's trust to your affiliate brand.
Mark?
Yeah, I think brand trust is huge. I mean, we see the customers generally don't leave money in their account. Makes them very transient. You know, they'll win one day, pull it all out, put it in the next. And the experience in the countries is even the biggest companies like MTN or something will just go down. So building a brand from an operator's point of view, and obviously sending your traffic to a trusted operator that they know 24 hours a day they get instant withdrawals, and there's no approval process on the withdrawals, and that, you know, those sorts of things are very, very important. And part of that element as an operator side is we have a bit of a focus on above the line advertising, because then you're saying we are actually here. We're not sat abroad and just got a license and can pull out of the country at any moment. We try and make sure we show local commitment as an operator, be it brand ambassadors or sponsoring events or above the line activity.
And I would actually give that same advice to affiliates, because above the line advertising is relatively cheap. I mean, you can advertise in the back of toilet doors in local pubs and things like that in South Africa for a really, really cheap rate, and that will help to build your brand. I think you probably know this better than me, but there's a new online shopping which is kind of like Amazon, but it's not Amazon in South Africa. It's a Cashalot or something. Take a lot. So thinking about your affiliate business, not just as a website where people come to find out information on where to bet, but actually building an affiliate business that brings you customers, not only from a gambling perspective, but from a retail perspective, because that is actually engaging audiences of the right age group, target segment, capital investment sector, that will actually help you to build your sports betting brand in those regions.
And I'd just add for the affiliate sort of approach in app to local operators is it's very cheap for operators to acquire customers. So doing rev share deals are always going to be the way to go with African operators, because I can go and advertise on radio and sign people up for $4 each. You know, so it needs to be the idea of bringing quality traffic, and therefore backing the traffic you bring to be worth a rev share deal, because I can go and do a radio ad myself and get a couple of thousand people in on a Saturday afternoon.
But I think the message here is that, yes, the operator, acquiring traffic is very cheap. It's that the operator doesn't know how to do it, so they need you badly. You just need to tell them how they should work to work with you. As soon as that bridge is down, as soon as they understand the value that the affiliate brings, there are so many customers to be onboarded in any country in Africa, really, because there's all of them are still mostly retail. But players start wanting to play from home. And if they play from home, they don't want to go on the retail or on the shops every day. They want to do it from their home, like we do in Europe and in many other countries. So the space is incredible. The amount of traffic to be driven is incredible, in my opinion.
And would you say, in your opinion or your experience, there's high demand for local content? So, for example, we know that a big part of the content that's consumed is, let's say, the Premier League, La Liga. The European leagues are very big, obviously, World Cup. We're talking mainly sports, because that's really what the market is really evolved in. But do people also follow the local leagues? And should affiliates be more attuned to what's happening for local events, or do you think it's just the global ones that are making the strides?
It does vary country to country. You'll find in South Africa, for example, the PSL, I think, dwarfs the Premier League. But maybe in Ghana, you'll think the Premier League would be much bigger than the local league. So I think you'd have to look at country to country. But the one thing that they always does generate when we're talking about chat rooms or the sort of crowd activities is, local guys giving opinions is important. And so, whether it's a local brand ambassador or someone who gives a blog post or something like that from a recognized face, that's quite key to also localize your product.
I think that South Africa is one of a kind, because every other country, they only look at Premier League, La Liga, and so on. But as Mark was saying, you need to have a local people commenting on that, creating the content about international leagues, but from someone that has been an ex-player, has been in the Premier League or whatever. That kind of content is what is being used and demand.
Yeah, absolutely, because I can tell you, I'm an Arsenal fan, and in Kenya, they always used to talk about Manchester United, Liverpool, and then Drogba went to Chelsea, and it was all about Chelsea, and I'm like, don't talk to me about Chelsea. Anyway, just agree with that 100%.
Not so, a good year for Arsenal.
Well, it's all right. We're getting there. But so what advice, if there was one thing you would say to our audience here, what would it be in terms of how can they take advantage of a rising star in our industry? How can they monetize their traffic? What opportunities exist for them? Anyone can start.
just, as I say before, sit down with the operator, convince them that you can bring value, because you can, because I've been there, I know how they work, you can bring value. And as soon as they, obviously Bet90 knows that, but Bet90 is one of a kind. There are so many others that didn't realize it yet. As soon as they will realize, and you need to explain them what you can bring to them. And don't be scared if you get 20% only revenue share, because the cost per acquisition is so low that you're still going to make money. And then they, as soon as they realize what you can do for them, that will increase.
So mine would be to affiliates to niche down, get really clear on which country in Africa you're going to go hard into, build your content, build your brand, and understand localization. That's the only way that you're going to be successful there.
I think just a general theme on African operators is a lot of them are making the move from retail to online. So there's a bit of a knowledge gap in even like how tracking works and how you can do reporting on it. So that's be wary that sometimes you're speaking to people and they won't know how to track your traffic properly. So you need to make sure that's in place as well.
But that will change. That will change. It's already changing. Like you say,
it is.
3 years ago it was only retail. Now we have customer coming up to us saying we want to open an operator in Ghana to only do online. All right, let's go.
Yeah, the demand is definitely growing, and we see it as well with requests for, I've now gone online, I need an affiliate program. I need to work with affiliates. How do I do it? So absolutely 100%, the trend is going, and obviously it's going to take time like any emerging market has in the past, but it's devolving and getting up there as well. So I'll open it up to you, to the floor, to ask any questions you've got. Take advantage, you might not get such free advice. Anyone? Don't be shy. Oh yes, there's one there.
David Altaner from Vixio Gambling Compliance. If affiliates say, oh, Europe is too difficult, we're tired of worrying about data protection, tired of worrying about age verification, affordability ban, credit card bans, and they treat Africa as the Wild West, what's the possible consequences of that?
Go on, guys. It's a good question.
I guess the Wild West, I was calling it the Wild West, is a bit of a general term. There are proper regulatory structures in place in most countries now. Licenses are multi-year licenses. Getting paid is international transfers are easy now, sometimes withholding tax, depending on to and from which country. So there's no difficulty in European affiliates doing deals for their African traffic with local African operators.
Yeah.
You can monetize it with local licensees, I think, no problem.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you. It's not like tomorrow you go there and they give you a license because you're funny. You need to actually apply, and the compliance is there. It might not be there like as in UK or like as in Sweden, but it's still there. So there is some kind of customer protection.
I mean, the regulation in South Africa is quite different. So when I was out there, I actually sat with the two governing parties in Cape Town, the DP and the ANC, and we were talking to the trade finance minister about how do they regulate it. And the problem is that the law hasn't been written yet in order to regulate what they're trying to regulate. So there's a big, big focus happening in South Africa in terms of writing the law that's going to help to put the regulation into place. They're very much aware of the fact that it needs to be done sooner rather than later. But these things take time. So there's a big focus on it. The key thing for me, which I found quite interesting when I was there, is they didn't even consider the affiliate piece. So they are just looking at the law from the player's perspective in terms of protecting the player and regulating the operator, but they haven't even considered if there are any rules or regulations that need to be in place for affiliates. So they're aware of it now, but they're not as advanced as what we are here, but they are looking to the UK and the US in terms of how, they've regulated that here to see if there are any frameworks that they can implement there. So it is very much on everybody's agenda.
Yeah, and just to add as well, I mean, as Mark said, obviously most of the operators are licensed now. There's some procedures in place to get them licensed and regulated. So there are protections, you know, they do verify age, and even the payment companies, they verify them as well. There's the KYC checks in place. Maybe they're not as stringent as it is in the UK, but, you know, when we started in the UK, you know, 10, 15 years ago, it wasn't as strict as it is today as well. So I think it's part and parcel of the evolving nature of an industry and in a marketplace, and that regulation will get tighter as it grows. But we're talking about very early stages in the affiliate world in Africa today. So it'll come, but don't worry, it'll be done properly. Any other questions? I hope you found it very valuable, and I hope you managed to pick up a few tips on what to focus on. So join me in thanking our wonderful panelists, and I look forward to seeing you all at the rest of the show. Thank you.
Stay away.